If you have a basis B for Rn and the vector x, you know how to compute x in the basis B, xb. If you have another basis C, you can compute in a similar way xc. But what if you start with xb and want to compute xc? Do you need to compute x first, or can it be done directly? That's what you will learn in this video. We'll do it in R2 just to keep the notation a bit simpler, a bit smaller. So we have three versions of R2, here, here, and here. On the top, we have the standard base for R2. The lower parts, we have here a basis B consisting of U1 and U2, and here a basis C consisting of V1 and V2. And now we know how to go from XB to X and from XC to X. For that, we have the matrices PB over here and PC over there. But can it be done in some more direct way? That's what we'll see. So let's look into an example. We have a basis B and a basis C. So it means that we can compute PB, just plug in the vectors into a matrix. We can also find its inverse. The determinant equals minus 1 times minus 1 equals 1. Minus 2 by 2 minus 4. So 1 minus 4 equals minus 1 over 3. So there we have our PB inverse. Shift the numbers on the diagonal and add minuses to the non-diagonal numbers. So if we have then some vector x over here, we can compute xb using our PB inverse. XB equals PB inverse times x equals minus 4 minus 2 equals minus 6 times minus 1 over 3 equals 2. And minus 8 minus 1 minus 9 times minus 1 over 3 equals 3. And similarly, we can compute xc. The inverse of the matrix PC is easy. The determinant is just 1. If shift the numbers on the diagonal and add the minus 1. So here we have our PC inverse times our x, and we get our xc over here. So there we are. So given some vector x, we can compute both xb and xc. Now, if we start with xb, second example, same basis, but second example. Now we start with some xb and want to find xc. Of course, we can compute our x first and then continue to compute xc. But let's see whether we can do it in a more direct way. So what we do is that we express our basis vectors, u1 and u2, the basis vectors of b. We try to express them in the basis vectors of c. So we start with u1 over here, minus 1, 2, and we want to find which such that u1 equals x1 times v1 plus x2 times v2. Well, the v1 and v2 are easy vectors now, so it's easy to find the weights. First, you choose your second constant such that the second component is okay, so you have to put a 2 here. And then in order to fix the first component, you need a minus 3. And in general, you have a vector equation, so you have u1 equals x1 times v1 plus x2 times v2, a general vector equation, so you need to form an augmented matrix, but then you can find these weights. So you have u1 equals minus 3 times v1 plus 2 times v2. And similarly for u2, u2 equals 3 times v1 minus v2. Okay, how can we use this? Now you know that your x equals 2 times u1 plus 3 times u2, because your xb equals 2, 3, so that means x equals 2 times u1 plus 3 times u2. Now you have expressed your u1 and u2 in terms of v1 and v2, so you plug in these expressions over here, and this allows you to write x in terms of v1 and v2, because now x equals minus 6 times v1 plus 9 times v1 equals 3 times v1, plus 4 times v2 minus 3 times v2, so plus v2. So now you have expressed your x in terms of v1 and v2, so you know, you can read off the coordinate vector with respect to c, your xc will be 3, 1. Or an alternative method, which you could also do, is you write again, you start of course with x equals 2 times u1 plus 3 times u2. Then you take its coordinate vector on the left and the right. This is bijective mapping, so you can do that to get xc equals the coordinate vector of 2 times u1 plus 3 times u2. Now this coordinate mapping is linear, so you can rewrite the right-hand side as 2 times u1 in c plus 3 times u2 in c. So you see the only thing you need is u1 in the basis c and u2 in the basis c. Well, we did this computation over here already, where we found that the coordinate vector of u1 in the basis c, how can you express u1 in terms of v1 and v2? Well, u1 equals minus 3 times v1 plus 2 times v2, so u1 in the basis c is minus 3, 2. And similarly, u2 in the basis c equals 3 minus 1. So plug in these expressions over here, and you'll find an alternative xc. So the important thing to notice is that the only thing you actually need to do this expression is to find u1 in the basis c and u2 in the basis c. And then you can express any vector xb as a new coordinate vector at xc. We'll use this idea, that's all you need later on to find the standard matrix of this mapping from xb to xc.